So sign convention in convex mirror. So this is the shape of the mirror. This is the pole, and we should place an object in front of the mirror. This is object. So as usual, P2O, the direction is reflected light direction. So P2O is U negative, where U is object distance. Now what is the nature of the convex mirror? The all light rays are appear to be diverge from one common point. It will be like this. Suppose if you increase the size of the object like this. So these are all the incident rays. So this will appear to be diverge at common point. This is F and this is C. So all light rays are appear to be diverge from F. So see the arrow marks. So what is the direction of focal point P to F? It is in the direction of incident light. That's why focal length will become positive in case of convex mirror. But at any position of the object, we have checked the six different situations in concave mirror. So here also, object at infinity, object at C, object between, object beyond C, object between F and C, object is at F, and object is placed between P and F, whatever may be the position, always it gives virtual and erect images. So P to C, radius of curvature is also positive. In case of concave mirror, radius of curvature is negative. So if image form between F and C or between P and F, whatever may be the position, you will get P to I is V positive. So this like we can apply the sign convention. That means in case of concave mirror, we can say that U is 10 centimeters. That means we should substitute minus 10. So such like that here the position of object above the principal and position of image also above the principal, but mostly diminished images between P and F or F and C it will create. So all positions are simply we can say that they are positive in the scale. So such like that we can apply the sign convention in convex mirror. So now we will see the relationship between the radius of curvature and focal length with the trigonometrical method. The relation between focal length small f and radius of curvature r. For this purpose, take a concave mirror. This is the concave mirror surface. Draw the principal axis. This is the position of object. Incident light ray. After the reflection, it passes through F, reflected light ray. This is P. This is M. This is N. So MN is the curved spherical concave mirror. So this is the object. So from this object, one light ray which is paraxial to the principal axis, the paraxial ray, touches the surface point M. From there it reflected and passes through F. From M to P, I draw a normal, and this normal touching the principal axis at position D, and the gap between D and P is very minute because this P is on the curve, but we should apply the trigonometrical method. That's why we are drawing the normal towards the curve onto the principal axis. So it creates a triangle MFD, and let us suppose the angle made here is 2 theta. How we can say it is 2 theta? In case of plane mirrors, normal is traveling exactly middle of the incident ray and reflected ray. But here, with respect to what we can find out the angle of incidence and angle of reflection, center of curvature. That means the normal line should drawn through the center of curvature. So like this. So center of curvature, this is angle of incidence, this is angle of reflection, and we can say that the angle I is equal to angle R. So let us suppose this is theta and theta. And we know that interior angle is sum of the exterior angles, that's why the angle is 2 theta. And here also it is creating an angle theta. So there are two triangles formed. Triangle MFD and triangle MCD. So from triangle MFD, tan 2 theta is equal to opposite by adjacent MD by FD. So from triangle MCD, tan theta is equal to opposite MD by adjacent CD. For small angles, tan theta will become theta. So tan theta approximately equal to theta. So therefore we can write tan 2 theta is 2 theta and tan theta is theta. Therefore tan 2 theta is approximately equal to t theta and tan theta approximately equal to theta. Now we can substitute these two values in these equations, then we can find out the relationship between F and R. So if tan 2 theta and tan theta will become 2 theta and theta, then we can apply 2 theta is equal to MD by FD. Similarly, theta is equal to MD by CD. So in place of theta, so I am writing MD by CD. So therefore this is equation 1 and 2. Let us write. So substituting equation 2 in 1. So therefore 2 into what is theta MD by CD is equal to MD by FD. So MD, MD get cancelled. 2 by CD is equal to 1 by FD. What is CD? D to C, radius of curvature. So therefore 2 by R is equal to 1 by, what is FD? Simply nothing but focal length. So therefore F is equal to R by 2. 1 by F is equal to 2 by R. So F is equal to R by 2. So focal length of a spherical mirror is equal to the half of the radius of curvature. Next one is mirror equation. So what we can understand from the mirror equation? So we should apply the rules of ray diagrams. So from this purpose, we should relate the position of object, position of image to the position of focal length. So for this purpose, I am taking one concave mirror. So exactly center pole of the mirror. So an object is placed in front of the pole of the mirror. So we should apply the rules of ray diagrams here. And this object, one incident ray touching the point of M on the curved surface, and after reflection it passes through F. And this is P. And P to F and F to C. One center of curvature is also we are drawing. Whenever one incident line or incident ray traveling through the center of curvature, it should be undeviated. It is undeviated. So it will reflect back to the center of curvature. So what we can understand from this, we'll try to extend it. So this is incident ray, and this is reflected, and this is touching the point N. And in between F and C, there is an inverted image formed, real and inverted image. And one more, if one incident ray exactly on the P, obliquely it goes to the down of the principal axis by maintaining the same angle of incidence and reflection. So I am drawing one more line which is towards the P. Like this. So incident ray which is touching a point M, after reflection it is passing through F. Incident ray which is obliquely make incidence on pole of the mirror, and it is reflecting by maintaining the same angle of reflection down of the principal axis. Incident ray which is traveling through the center of curvature, it is undeviated and reflect back to the same path.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.